was. It's your calling. Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
It's nearly over. Finish it.
Sargon!
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path. Align yourself.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd. Challenged by the giantess. wherever you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess. Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sickbed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize. Half black, half color of flesh, and her face menacing and grim.
Not a warrior, you're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword, pick it up, fight the darkness, fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
stormy seas and lost souls.
She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be?
So stupid.
Everyone hates her. She's a curse.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. The warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there is no one left to do that for you.
Everywhere.
You failed. What's that?
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just
do
like
it,
your sword.
Do it. Come on. There.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling. A song. Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. barely functioning. She rarely left the house. Her father, Zimbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely.
The Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Sigurd. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
Thank you.
Watching from afar, she mimicked him.
Perfecting her own secret dance. Wishing those fleeting moments of light would stretch out to last.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not. I don't leave home much.
Oh. Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you. And.
You. Learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dilly. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who is supposed to reassure you. Make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northman took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, and don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No!
And all your suffering will have been for nothing!
Shut up!
Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister. and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens. King in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrving.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong.
Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
I can feel the dead in the air. You can feel the dead. Why did you do this? Turn back. Why would you bring her here?
It's not the same.
Take the torch. It's too dark.
Take it.
This will help you.
Careful.
You have to be able to see.
I'm here. I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember?
He's gone.
There he is.
Dillian,
there he is. Finally.
You found him. What's wrong? What happened? Can you hear me? Just wait there. I'll find you.
What's wrong with you? Can't you find him? What's happened to him?
Him.
What's that? Did you hear that?
Nothing. Was that voices?
Is that his voice or the voice of the dead?
Not Dillian.
Dillian's calling to you. Can
Where
you hear
is he?
Him?
Where is he?
He sounds like he's getting further away.
Have you lost him?
You're going the wrong way.
Are you lost?
Senua. You remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving. Disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
He's going to save you.
Find the voice.
Find him.
Me to find him. I'm lost without him.
That's not Dillian.
It's not Dillian.
Find a way. There's always a way. Don't stop now. Don't give up now. Find a way. You're too close to stop.
Dillian wants me to face my fears. I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it in my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy.
Chief Benson.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said it could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you,
no.
They will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come. Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
It's done. You did it, but there's more. Go away. There's more. You're tired, but you have to keep going. There's still more. It's not going to be easy. Can we do another one? It's too much. Have you got the energy? She hasn't got the energy.
No.
Too much to do.
Dillian.
want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
Is broken.
There's no way you can fix it.
What do you do now, Sam?
Stay. Let's stay here.
He's waiting for you.
He always said he would wait.
He's close.
It's about you.
He's close. He loves you.
His love calling you.
Dillian. Dillian, we're here.
Dillian.
Open the gate.
She can't.
Open the gate.
It's locked. Try harder.
She can't.
The gate.
She can't.
She can't.
She will.
Dillian.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through
him before he disappears.
Dillian, don't lose him.
Way too many times.
You always let him disappear.
Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not in there.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The dark.
The dark world.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. Senua explored new paths into the unknown. Do you remember him whispering in your ear?
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
You can't go up there. Not in this world.
No. Not in this world.
You can't.
Nobody will love
you. Can you remember what it feels like?
Look what happens to the future.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
Doesn't know who killed
Loki
him.
Makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hoof, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoof says, "I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon."
Years Loki. Had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go. And she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past. And Dillian, her future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
That are most precious to you.
What if these trials mean nothing? It's nothing that you learned that I didn't use.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Balder. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, I cannot see where Balder stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon. Loki replies, here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands. And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Balder. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Balder is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
Dillion saved her.
You owe your life to Dillion.
You owe everything to him.
What if they're all about wasting your time, just delaying minute by minute by minute? What does she think she's doing? She thinks she can.
They mean nothing.
In a way that nobody else is
special.
A waste of time.
Could all be a waste of her time.
What if the gods are just
playing?
What if the gods are lying?
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Balder. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief, and she dies. She's put next to her husband, and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
Your love because he believed in you. He's the reason she's alive at all.
runes. You see runes everywhere.
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur. Weep him out of hell. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they find in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
Dillion didn't believe in the curse. Dillion believed in you.
Nobody will love you.
Listen to your father when you had the chance.
Why didn't you listen to me?
His love has tortured you, and it tortures me.
Dillion!
Druids, like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillion's arms, glad to see the world through his eyes. Slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Senua. Your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you and only you can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? The gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I know.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong? What if this is nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick. It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know.
It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it.
This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels... It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange. Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
This is wrong. This has to be wrong.